So this is my CyberPower 1000 watt UPS. Probably about the last year, I think the battery has been going, and it's to the point now if UPS has to switch over to battery power, it just shuts off. So it hasn't thrown any error codes, but it just doesn't do anything. So the utility company is doing some work on the power lines outside today. So I figure that's a good day, good time to replace the battery in this UPS. So last year, I'd actually picked up this battery, 9 amp hour, 12 volt battery that's the same size in there. But then the other thing I wanted to try is I also picked up a 10 amp hour lithium iron phosphate battery. So my plan for one of these batteries is I also have to replace the battery in my Harbor Freight backpack sprayer. It's kind of to the same point. It's 8 years old like this one, and the battery's at the point where if you run the sprayer for maybe 10 minutes, it starts beeping low voltage. But I wanted to try this one. I'll probably put this in the backpack sprayer. The nice thing is it's lighter. It's probably half the weight of this battery. The battery in the backpack sprayer, I think, is a little bit larger than this one, but I thought I would get a lithium iron phosphate to try. This listing said it would work in a UPS, although 10 amp maximum discharge current, which in a 12 volt UPS is only about 100 watts. So what I figured I would do is plug this battery in here and see what kind of load this UPS can handle before it shuts off with that battery. This is supposed to be rated up to like 1,000 volt amps, and I think it's 600 or 700 watts, which would be 60 or 70 amps most likely. Anyway, I thought I would plug this in and just see kind of what happens with it. And if it doesn't work, it's going in the backpack sprayer, and I'll plug this into the UPS. The battery seems to only be at 13 volts right there, 13.1 basically. Power went off 20 minutes ago, and it's already dropped 7/10 of a volt. So pretty easy to change the battery. There's just, you pull out one screw there, Phillips head, and then you slide this over and it pops out. And then you can pull the battery out here, and then I think I'll have to get some pliers to get these terminals off. They're really tight. Okay, got the old battery out. Feels like it might be bulging a little bit. Plug this one in and we'll see if this thing will power up. Okay, I've got the lithium iron phosphate plugged in there, and let's see if you have to hold that. Okay, there we go. Yeah, you have to hold the button down for a while. Okay, so that's battery, thinks the battery is fairly charged. It's gone through 209 loss of power events over the last 8 years. Zero input, 120 output, 60 hertz. Okay, there I've got a 150 watt heat lamp plugged in. Let's see what it's saying. So 4 minutes run time. Now, I didn't charge this battery up. 138 watts. It's running that. That's, you know, 138 watts. Let's see what the voltage is here. Okay, yeah, the battery voltage is like at 11.4 volts. That's interesting. So, yeah, let me try plugging in the lead acid battery and see what that does. Yeah, so I've got the lead acid battery in there. It's sitting at 12.7 volts. I charged it a few months ago, but it's just been sitting since then, so it may have discharged a little bit. Heat lamp running. Let's just see what the voltage reads here. I'll just read it off. Down 11.4 as well. So it gives basically the same readings on both batteries. Yeah, so I have my light bar over here. There's four approximately 150 watt heat lamps in there, and I have them on switches. So right now I have all the lights or the heat lamp switched off, and you can see we're getting 0 watts there. So let's see if it still work. Okay, there we picked up 150 watts. And let's see, my battery was reading about 13.5. Let's see what we're getting now. And we're down to 12. Okay, so that's 150. Let's switch on number two. Oh, there we go. We've got 300 watts. And now the battery is flashing. Oh, yeah. That's pretty much what I thought. If that's only rated for 33 amps, that's about 300 watts. So, yeah, these 10 amp hour lithium iron phosphate batteries are not suitable for a UPS. I guess up to maybe 250 watts they might work. Let's see what we got here. Yeah, it's back to 13 volts. So let's see, I can turn it back on. There's 150 watts. So yeah, it's okay with 150, but as soon as you go up from there, 280, 300, battery flashes, and then it shuts off. Yeah, so I think the BMS inside that lithium iron phosphate battery, just like it says here, peak current 33 amps for 10 seconds, and that's about, you know, at 300 watts with the conversion and everything, that's probably 30 some amps at 12 volts. The listing for the battery says UPS, and it even says cyber power, so it's physically the right size and it's the right volts and amp hour rating. In fact, it's 1 amp hour better than the lead acid. This was a 9 amp hours, that one is 10. So on paper you would say this is a better battery, but it's only good for 30 amps or roughly 300 watts. Okay, yeah, I got this plugged in the wall now. So you can see we're getting 120 volts there. See if I can get my meter up there, and we'll check the charging voltage here. 13.2. Might just let that sit there for a while. Yeah, I think this might work with lithium if you had a large enough battery. So you'd probably need, you know, at least 50 or maybe 100 amp hour battery to go in there to handle the current. So I think this one says on the circuit board, I think it said 60 amps was the maximum current on the 1000 unit. They have a 600 unit that I think was 40 amps, and then this one said 60 amps. Okay, there's the UPS working again. So it's, yeah, showing just around 300 watts. So that's just to show you I couldn't use that lithium iron phosphate battery, because if the UPS were to kick on now, it would shut off in 10 seconds, so it wouldn't be very useful. But yeah, it looks like everything's working again. Got it all cleaned up inside, all the yellow glue is all gone, and new battery in there. So yeah, this will probably last for another 6 or 7 years, and yeah, I'll either have to replace the lead acid battery or I'll go with a larger lithium iron phosphate. So I just wanted to show you that here. As always, thanks for watching.